संभाले है, तब से जो मेट्रो सिटी है उनके पोटेंशियल के बारे में और कनेक्टिविटी के बारे में उनको ज्यादा वो प्रयत्न कर रहे हैं। वैसे पीपीपी मॉडल की जो बात आती है, सूरत एकमात्र शहर है जिसका हम लोगों ने 3 करोड़ डिपॉजिट के साथ में कनेक्टिविटी के लिए जो पहला प्रयत्न किया था, तो पीपीपी मॉडल पे एक्सटेंशन का एयरपोर्ट के मॉडर्नाइजेशन का क्या उनका प्रावधान है, और जो नरेंद्र भाई ने इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट के लिए सूरत में नींव रखी थी तो वो कब तक एक्सटेंड कर पाएंगे, तो उसी के बारे में मैं आपके माध्यम से पूछना चाहती हूँ।
सर, आई कैन ओनली एंडोर्स व्हाट द ऑनरेबल मेंबर इज सेइंग दैट द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैड लेड द ग्राउंड ब्रेकिंग सेरेमनी द स्टोन एंड दैट वी विल नाउ परस्यू दिस टू सी बिकॉज शी वॉन्ट्स टू नो द स्पेसिफिक टाइम बाय विच वी विल कंप्लीट इट। Now I'm not carrying those details with me because that is a very airport specific project specific issue, but I will share those with the honorable member.
Shri Sougat Rai ji.
Thank you, sir. I'm very grateful. Sir, recently the Ministry of Civil Aviation has taken a decision to privatize 3 airports including Thiruvananthapuram and Ahmedabad. They have been handed over to the Adani Group for modernizing, Lucknow also. Now this is handing over assets built with government money to private parties. Few years ago, there was also a proposal to privatize Kolkata and Chennai airports. Now this was withdrawn in the face of determined opposition by the workers and all concerned people in the country. Now the minister mentioned that they have been preparing a master plan for developing a cost effective way to add capacity to meet future traffic demand at Kolkata and Lucknow airport. I'd like to ask the honorable minister if you would assure us that no further effort would be made to privatize the Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport at Calcutta, which has been modernized recently at a cost of 2,300 crores. I'd like him to assure us that this is not being privatized, which will be totally against the interest of the workers and the state.
Sir, I will confine myself to saying that the government has taken a decision to privatize 6 airports. This was a decision taken in November of 2018. Out of these, we are proceeding with 3 of them. In respect of 2 others, I think we've resolved all the other issues. What further program of privatization we undertake, etc., is, well, there was a bid invited for 6 airports, and out of those 6 airports, 1 bidder was the succeeded in all 6 bids. We have taken a decision in respect of 3 of these airports to hand it over to that bidder. I can give you the name. It is Adani Enterprises. Yes, 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 yes. And one minute. And the bid document, if you look at it, unlike the previous period when bids were confined to just 1 or 2 bidders and we received low bids, this one received 9 bids. And all of them were at an international class, and I can tell you they were extremely successful. And in fact, I would welcome a discussion on what was done to the civil aviation sector during an extended period of time when my friends were in office.
Thank you.
I'd be happy to have that business and what you did to that sector. I'd be very happy.
आप लिखकर
दीजिए. I'd be happy to have the discussion in the house.
आप
माने सदस्य. We will then talk about civil aviation rights. We will say what about airport. What about Kolkata? When we reach that point,
माने मंत्री जी, आप उनका जवाब मत दीजिए.
It is not my job to give assurances on hypothetical things. If we come to the conclusion that a particular airport, we receive a demand that it needs to be privatized, we will look at the issue on merits. I am in no position to give private assurances to honorable members.
Thank you.
That's not a minister's job.
Question number 462, Sri Haji Fazul Rahman.